Live from the all-new Legend Studio in Ottawa, Tennessee, it's Tropical Country with B-Dawg and Lou, right here on Tiki Man Radio.
Uh-oh, guess what day it is? Guess what day it is? Hump Day!
One rowdy cowboy throw down here in H-Town, where we're stronger than a hurricane. From miles around, the best of the best come here to put their tough to the test. Give it all for gold or go home broke when they open up that gate. Welcome to the show, welcome to the home of the world's biggest rodeo, where the stars light up the night underneath that Texas sky. Welcome to the show, are you ready for a ride? Yeah, you better buckle up and hold on tight, where the Bayou City streets meet the country roads. Welcome to the show. It's a Houston tradition, 4-H, FFA, and Go Texan. And you can bet, son, it's gonna be around a long, long time. These riders and ropers give it their best. We'll show them how loud the hometown crowd can get. Cause tonight, y'all, we all got a little bit of cowboy deep inside. Welcome to the show, welcome to the home of the world's biggest rodeo, where the stars light up the night underneath that Texas sky. Welcome to the show, are you ready for a ride? Yeah, you better buckle up and hold on tight, where the Bayou City streets meet the country road. You better buckle up and hold on tight, where the Bayou City streets meet the country roads. Where the Bayou City streets meet these country roads. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show.
Oh yeah, welcome to the show. Going to be a great night tonight. Welcome to Tropical Country with B-Dawg and Lou, right here on Tiki Man Radio. We are where the boots meet the beach. And, of course, we are broadcasting live on Tiki Man Radio, tikimanradio.com, and the Tiki Man Radio YouTube channel, courtesy of the MFG Records Tropical Live Cam. Of course, our show is brought to you by JBL Legend Travel, JBL Travel Group, the official travel company of Tiki Man Radio. When you're planning your next getaway, don't scour the internet trying to find promo codes or the best deal. Use a professional like Joe Leo, JBL Travel Group. It doesn't cost you anymore, so why wouldn't you? They're only one phone call away. It's 732-831-5200. Of course, GTS Charters, goaltending services down in Key West, Florida, is the premier charter service down in Key West. When you're visiting the Keys, make sure you get out on the water, and there's no better people to do it with than Monty and Gypsy there at Goaltending Services. And, of course, before you get out there on that boat, make sure you visit Goaltending Outfitters at 5110 Overseas Highway there in Key West. You can get everything that you need. You can get your coffee, get your snacks, get whatever you need to go out on the water, your suntan lotion, and don't forget your GTS swag, and you can also get some awesome souvenirs from local Key West artists. And if you want to know more, you want to book a cruise, give them a call at 305-916-0990. And of course, Party Dog Entertainment. What is Party Dog Entertainment? Well, of course, that is yours truly. I want to create the soundtrack for your next event, and we want to do it with reasonable prices. If you want to get a hold of me at 423-847-2454 and or partydogentertainment at gmail.com. Together, we want to have a howling good time. And of course, yes, Facebook and I are still immortal enemies. They have legitimately have blocked my website on Facebook. I tried tonight, you know, when we're doing all the sponsors and stuff on Tiki Man Radio, I list all the sponsors. I put my web address on there, and they would not post it. Even as Tiki Man Radio posting it, they will not let anybody share my website. So I had to take it out just to get that to post on Tiki Man Radio. So you can go to Party Dog Entertainment over on Facebook. We do have a Facebook page, and you can find all the information out there as well as what the website is. So you can check all that out, and we appreciate it if you do. Of course, since they've done that, I'm going to rely heavily on you. The word of mouth to get it out there. You know anybody that's having an event and they want a kick-ass DJ? Well, tell them about Party Dog Entertainment and so we can have a great time. All right. Well, of course, Laura Lou is in the house.
Hey, y'all.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. We're not sitting in a sunset tonight.
I know.
Everything is the bright color that it should be.
Right.
I do not believe we should be blowing anybody out on the sound tonight. Everything should be good. I spent a lot of time in here getting everything.
You did. Well, you know, some folks are listening in, some folks who told us last week whenever it was jacked up. So hopefully they're not saying anything about it so far, so we might be good.
Well, nothing was jacked up when I was testing it, so.
No, it really wasn't. It wasn't. Well, I want to give a big shout out to Moni. She's out there tonight.
Well, hello, Moni.
And she noticed I got my hair cut. She said she likes it.
Of course, we have to say hello to Vacuum Cleaner Tom.
That's right. I love that. Also want to give a big shout out to Maureen. She's out there tonight.
Hey, Maureen.
And there's a lot of folks watching on YouTube, but
not a lot of people commenting. No.
So,
okay.
Not sure what's going on there. But Ed Kubiak and Felicia, the appetizer girl, they're out there tonight.
Yeah, and they're part of that peace train. They're a couple of the conductors.
That's right. And Ed and Pat, the actual peace train.
Ed messaged me today and he goes, I got a recording of a train whistle for you. I will send it to you. And I'm like, he must not like the one I have.
but a real one's always better.
A real one's always better.
So, yeah, hi to Ed and Pat. Thank you for tuning in. Mr. Billy Rieger is out there tonight.
Hey, Billy.
Hello from Crown Point, Indiana. Nice to see you back with us.
Yeah.
And I think, actually, that's all that is chiming in right now.
Well, just remember, if you are watching on YouTube, you have to like and subscribe to be able to get into that live chat.
Yep.
And if you've done that and you're new and you've never been in that live chat, there should be three little bars over there that'll take you right to that live chat. So, but you do have to like and subscribe. That was one safety procedure that the Tiki Man had to take, be able to cut out all the spammers
that were
interrupting every show. So
people like you, babe. At least according to Facebook.
Yeah, according to Facebook, I am a spammer, which just irritates me. I'm on Facebook, you know, because I've registered on all these different Facebook pages and groups, you know, for like weddings and events and things like that. And a couple of them are legitimately for vendors to advertise. And so, you know, I posted on all them and somehow, some way.
And it's to people that have said,
yes,
looking for a professional DJ for my event, blah, blah, blah. So we're like, check out partydogentertainment.com.
Yeah.
And
boom.
Spammer.
Spam. I had 17 posts removed by Facebook for spamming.
Although I was able to share it the other day.
Oh, was you?
And I didn't get it taken down, but it was on my personal page.
Now, I did
I
get
couldn't share it as Party Dog.
I did get alerted today. I actually took down one of our Tropical Country B-Dawg and Lou posts where I mentioned Party Dog Entertainment. They also took down too. So it seems to be that nobody can share my web address. So share my Facebook page, Party Dog Entertainment, and I'll take them over there and give them all the information there as well.
That's right. Well, Maureen chimed in. She said she didn't get any notification that we went live, so maybe that's why there's not as many people today.
Wow.
So
I have no control over that. That is totally a YouTube thing.
Facebook just loves us. Ed Kubiak. So, Ed, I know you watch YouTube on your TV. To do it, to join the live chat, you have to be on your phone, I believe. Your phone or your computer.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't think that the TVs will let you join the live chat.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Whenever I've watched it on TV, I've never seen a live chat function from the TV. So even on, you know, on them big smart TVs, I haven't seen a live chat. So
yeah,
you have to be on your phone or your computer or something like that to be able to jump in that live chat. So
yeah. But thank you for thinking of us anyway.
Yeah.
We're glad you're here. You're always welcome to keep messaging me on Messenger.
That's right.
All right.
What else you got?
I think that, well, I have, listen.
I knew there had to be something.
So, I do have some things.
Okay.
But we can wait until in a little bit.
We can wait.
We can wait.
It can wait a minute.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, Tom reminded Moni. That's how she knew to get on.
Oh, well, very good.
Thank you, Tom.
That gets him a second vacuum cleaner salute right there.
That's right. And also, I want to say hello to the mystery man. We can't forget about the mystery man.
Hello to the mystery man. All right. Anything else?
Not yet.
All right. Well, if you are out there watching on the YouTube, get in that live chat, say hey so we can say hey back to you. If you're out there on the radio listening, no problem. Just jump on the Tropical Country B-Dawg and Lou Facebook page, and you can message us that way as well. There's lots of ways you can get a hold of us. So.
Absolutely.
So, how about let's just get the show kicked off, and then when we come back, we'll hopefully have some more shout-outs and story time and who knows what we're going to get into. How about a little Mike Medall? You, me, and Mexico.
Lisa from Marion, Arkansas. I love tuning in to Tropical Country with B-Dawg and Lou every Wednesday from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Eastern on Tiki Man Radio.
I'm low on gas, I'm running late, all backed up on the interstate, but I found myself a 20 in the ashtray. My pants are fitting a little tight, but that cake was worth every bite. Mama says God made me just right. It ain't perfect, but I believe that. Yeah, it's all about the way you see it. 'Cause the grass is greener on my side. Got the sun shining down on me just right. Turned off the news, went outside to spend a little borrowed time, soaking up and breathing in that good life. It ain't always perfect, but I believe it. Oh, it's all about the way you see it. 'Cause the grass is greener on my side. Got the sunshine just right. Yeah, I have my share of problems, but I gotta say it's a good day to have a good day. Yeah, good day to have a good day. Yeah. I'm not perfect, I'll never be.
Oh, yeah. Good day to have a good day. That is Jesse Lee. And before that was Mike McDonald. Both of those are newly released songs, so they're pretty good.
Yeah, I like those.
Yeah.
Good for a nice spring day.
Yeah, the warm weather. It is beautiful outside.
It is.
And hopefully that just means we got great weather ahead of us.
Well, I do want to give a big sorry. You know how I am about the chat. I do want to give a shout out. Lots more people are jumping on now.
I got to get that sound bite. Squirrel!
Oh. You do. Donna Cummings, hello what? To you.
Well, hello to Donna and the Panther.
She's jumping on for a little bit, she says.
And we got to say hi to Bob, too.
Oh, yeah. Hi, Bob.
We say hi to her and the Panther. We can't forget about Bob.
I know. Panther is out for a walk.
Oh.
She's going to be mad she missed the horses. Panther likes the horses in our video.
Oh, okay. Well, that's just for the Panther.
Hello to Jeff McCarty.
Hey, Jeff.
Tiki Man said, I thought those horses were being frisky.
Well, you never know.
Listen, I didn't tell you, but when I was looking at video clips for that specific one.
You found horses being frisky?
I did.
Oh, no.
And I put them in the video.
Oh, they are?
No.
Oh.
I put them in there.
You're not realizing it.
Not realizing. And then when I watched it back, I was like, oh, like it was all out in the open, if you know what I'm saying. So I was like, yeah, we'll switch that out.
We got to make this PG, by golly.
That's right. So no, they're not in the video anymore.
Good thing.
Right. And Mr. Eric Tittle says,
I-O, brother. So.
And lovely Larice.
Hello to the lovely Larice. Every time I say that, I just want to, like Hannibal Lecter, hello, Larice.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they were happy horses, Tiki Man. Mo wants to know when your spring break is, babe.
My spring break is over.
That's right.
Yeah.
Last.
My spring break
last
was.
Week?
Yep.
Last week, Mo.
No, 2 weeks ago now.
Has it been that long?
Yeah. Yeah. We were on spring break during the time change. So that, yeah.
Oh, that's right.
So
a week after the time change.
Yeah, they started doing that. Helps kids adjust.
Listen.
So, yeah, we have spring break in the second week of March.
Yeah.
That sucks.
Yeah. Well, speaking of spring, we have Easter coming up this weekend.
Yes. Yes, we do.
Do you know how many? So we're empty nesters now.
Mm-hmm.
All of our kids are grown.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, our youngest is getting ready to turn 20.
Mm-hmm. You want to depress us even more.
Right. Do you know how many messages I've gotten from those kids?
Wanting to know about their Easter
wanting
baskets?
No. Yes. Like, and it's always like memes. Like, I got one today. It was like a little sketch.
Mm-hmm.
And it was this girl sitting in a car and she's like, I'm leaving the house. Mom kicked me out. Mom doesn't love me anymore. Blah, blah, blah. And the mom's like, I never said that. And she's like, yeah, you said you weren't getting me an Easter basket. That's the same thing. I have gotten those kind of memes and sketches for the last, like, 3 weeks. I thought I was going to get away with no Easter bunny in this house this year.
Well, last year, their Easter basket contained, it was a laundry basket.
Yeah.
We got them a chocolate bunny, but the rest of it was just cleaning supplies for their houses.
And they were pretty excited.
So they were, yeah, they're like, cool. I think we got them a chocolate bunny and I think some microwave popcorn or something like that.
Things.
Some little things, but the majority of it was cleaning supplies and a laundry basket.
Right.
And that was their Easter baskets last year.
Yeah. Yeah, they seem to like it, but yeah, this year they're already on the.
It's pretty sweet when you can go Easter shopping at the Dollar Tree.
Right. Which.
I know. Listen. I know what you're going to say because I sent it to you.
So. The Dollar Tree put out a thing. They are now raising their maximum price in the store to $7.
So it's not the Dollar Tree anymore.
It's not the Dollar Tree.
Just like Dollar General is not Dollar General. It hasn't been Dollar General in years.
Right.
But the Dollar Tree, you always knew you go in and get everything for a buck or...
Then they raised it to $1.25.
$1.20 now? And $7?
Now, well, they have some things now that are $5.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, so they're going to be raising those things to $7.
Well, I heard...
still much cheaper than anywhere else, but...
Well, I heard somebody say, I haven't been in a Five Below for maybe once or twice in my entire life. We have one here in town. We don't go to it.
Yeah.
But I've been there a couple times. But the whole premise of that store is everything is $5 and below.
They lie now.
I guess it's like $20 and below now.
Wow.
Is what
really? What
some people have commented said. Yeah, they have things in there. It's like $20. So.
Wow.
So,
Moni, it's a maximum $7.
You just need to start changing your store's names because it's false advertisement at this
right?
point. And I'm waiting for somebody to sue them for it.
You know what? I would not doubt it.
Somebody sues them for everything else.
Right?
So, trust me, you want to talk about suing. You know, I don't know, sometimes when you see stuff on TikTok, you don't know if people are serious or if it's satire or what it is.
It's on the internet, it has to be.
It has to be true. But there is legitimately a girl on there who says that she's never had a job and she makes her living suing people. And those are what her TikToks are all about, is about all the different people and everything, businesses and things that she has sued them for.
Really?
Mm-hmm. And so the most recent one that she's had out is that, you know, she had a baby. And, you know, she, her and her partner, they wanted a baby. So they went and to a facility and got a donation to be able to have a baby. Well, her partner left her because her partner said, yeah, I didn't want this family thing. So her partner left.
Mm-hmm.
And her thing is, now I'm trying to get the address and everything of the donor, and I'm going to try to get him to pay child support.
Stop it.
No, I kid you not. That's why I said, I don't know if this stuff is satire or what, but this girl, if she legit does the things that she says she has done, oh my God. Number one, the attorney that takes her cases.
Right.
But I really hope it is all satire, but there is a long list of things that she says that she has sued people for, and that's how she makes her living.
I don't know. Somebody sued McDonald's and became a millionaire for hot coffee.
Mm-hmm.
Which, after I read the whole story about that, it made a little bit more sense to me, but still.
Yeah, she, another one that she did, she said that she went to go get a massage.
Mm-hmm.
And when she got there, you know, the lady was like, you know, I'll be right with you. Just got to get the room cleaned up, ready to turn over, and I'll be right with you.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, I was 3 minutes past my appointment time when she took me in there.
Stop it.
And she's like, okay, I'm willing to let 3 minutes slide. But then she cut my, then she said, okay, well, your massage is done. And she's like, no, you still owe me another 3 minutes. And she goes, no, hon, your time was up at 11. It's 11. She goes, but you got me in here 3 minutes late. So you owe me 3 minutes. And the lady's like, it doesn't work that way. She says, I got another customer coming.
Oh, no.
And she said she was going to sue over 3 minutes.
Really?
Yeah. So I really hope that is a satire. I really, really do. Too,
but, you know, there are people out there. I'm just saying.
Yeah, so there's anything you can see on TikTok.
Well, yeah.
I don't know. Maybe they should ban it.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know.
Eric Tittle says, I thought Five Below was for people 5 feet and shorter. Moni said her dollar store now has a $1.50 minimum.
$1.50 minimum.
Yeah. So they're really not the dollar store.
No.
Because nothing is a dollar.
Well, in all honesty, if you go into the dollar store, can you find anything that's a dollar?
In the Dollar Tree, you can.
Dollar Tree, but Dollar General, no.
Oh, no.
Dollar Tree, yes, you have, but obviously that's going to start changing, so.
Yeah.
And that's where we went and got all of our cheap crap.
Right.
You know, going to have a party, great place to go get your paper plates and and everything, so.
Well, I like getting like crafty stuff. Like if I'm going to make a wreath, they have so much good like ribbon and the frames and, you know, all that stuff. So, and it's a lot cheaper than going to Hobby Lobby or Joann's or somewhere like that. So, Tiki Man. Yes, Tiki Man. Thank you for reminding us. So the two newest sponsors of Tiki Man Radio, Reef Rum and Lake Winnie.
Yeah.
So congratulations and thank you. So you got to taste the reef rum. I didn't get to taste it this week.
I did. The reef rum, it, you know, cause you know, I love my coconut rum.
Yes.
And, I've tried some other kinds of rums. It's a sweet, but smoky, rum.
It sounded really interesting.
You know, when you take a swig of it, it's like, ooh, it's almost like a, in my opinion, it's almost like a whiskey hybrid. I mean, it's rum, but it has
that
smoky flavor like you get in a lot of whiskeys. But because it's rum, it's still a little bit sweet.
Nice.
But it's really, really nice. And it has.
Yeah, we're going to have to get us some.
It has just the right amount of burn. But one thing that we learned, because the Beach Buddha was chiming in.
I heard it was good with
and
that.
He's like, I put it in my coffee. And I'm like, what?
You so, like putting stuff in your coffee.
I love putting stuff in my coffee. I dumped what I had left in my glass and dumped it in my coffee.
Yeah.
And it's fantastic in coffee. So,
nice.
Yeah. It's an all-purpose rum.
Nice.
But yes, it is sweet and smoky with, you know, just the right amount of burn.
And I really,
and I'm not a whiskey guy because I really can't stand, I don't like, you know, the that burn and all that. But it was really, really good.
Well, and I heard them saying, and I really liked this thought, that they were going to stick with one thing and do mm-hmm. that one thing
and
really
do it
well.
Very, very well.
And I think a lot of people fall into, you know, they put something out there, it goes over well. So then mm-hmm. they're like, okay, let's
add
do
this,
more.
Let's add
do more.
That.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think sometimes that takes away from the quality and the specialness mm-hmm. of the product. So
absolutely.
I was kind of excited when I heard them say that. So Reef Rum, welcome to the Tiki Man Radio family.
Yeah.
And then, of course, Lake Winnie.
Lake Winnie, yeah.
We are going this summer.
You know, it's almost criminal, the fact that we have been here. Almost
8 years.
And we've never been to Lake Winnie. I have driven past it.
Me too.
Probably a dozen times. But, you know, never stopped, never had, you know, because our kids weren't little, so didn't
right.
have any, you know, and... The littles don't come down and visit us that often.
And our teenagers did go.
They went, yeah, but they went
without us.
They went on their own.
Yeah.
So they didn't want to take us.
No.
But, you know, the littles, all the grandkids and everything, haven't been down here when they've been open.
Yeah.
Just because of the time of the year. So,
yeah.
Sounds like I think we're going to be able to go and visit because, you know.
Yeah. I really want to.
Since they're a new sponsor, I think, and the Tiki Man used to work there.
Oh, that's right.
So I think it's only appropriate that Tiki Man takes us all on a field trip to give us the tour.
Oh,
how about
yeah.
that?
Company field trip.
That's
like
right.
That.
Company field trip.
I like it. Laurie said she's never been to Lake Winnie either. See, Laurie, tell Danny company field trip.
Well, he almost lost me when he said that, you know, his one job was to stand at the top of the one ride and make sure that there were no
yeah.
snakes. He almost lost me. I'm like, mm-hmm.
You wouldn't have had that.
You said snakes. I hate snakes.
Lake Winnie, Moni. Lake Winnie is here
Lake
in Chattanooga.
Lake Winnipesaukee.
Lake Winnipesaukee.
Yeah.
Is it East Ridge?
It's actually in Georgia.
Okay. That's right. It's right over.
It's right over the line
right in
Georgia. And
they still consider it.
It is an old school amusement park.
Yep.
Yeah, you've been there since the early 1950s, I believe. Tiki Man can correct me on that.
Yeah.
It may be older than that, but it's been there a minute.
Mo. Maureen, I just love you. She said Tiki Man can do the Lake Winnie field trip because it's not past Nashville. That's right. Tiki Man does not go past Nashville.
Yeah.
He doesn't go as far as Nashville if he can help it.
Just like that guy don't go past mile marker 10 very often.
That's right.
Unless he's doing it for Brody.
That's right. And we want to send our wishes out to Brody.
Absolutely.
And that guy, poor Brody, looked so pitiful the last, week and a half since he had his eye surgery.
And I think that guy has been...
He's been a mess.
I know.
That poor guy.
That's his buddy right
it
there.
It is his buddy. But they were out together today on the golf cart, out riding mm-hmm. around Key West again. So mm-hmm. Brody is making some progress.
Very nice. You know, that is one spoiled-ass dog.
It is.
So
he deserves it. Brody is so cute.
I got to get up and then, I got to go wander around my own private beach.
Right.
And then...
His life is so hard.
We got to go to town. I got to get on that golf cart and then have people look at me and pet me.
Right.
What a poor life for a dog.
A hard life. I know. I know. Isn't that funny?
You know, to say to have a dog's life, you know. I'm just saying.
I would have Brody's.
That's right. He gets spoiled.
He does.
So, but he has had a hard time, and you know, hopefully he is on the mend.
I hope so, too. He was so pitiful in the cone of shame. for those of you who watched Up, the Disney movie.
Mm-hmm.
Was it Pixar? Pixar.
Yeah.
The Cone of Shame.
The Cone of Shame.
Poor Brody had to wear it for a while.
Mm-hmm.
But so hopefully he's getting better.
Anything else?
Nope.
Well, I will tell.
Well, I do, but you know.
I will tell you, we are planning on having guests in studio, hopefully very, very soon. We've been talking to, a dozen artists about getting dates in here, trying to get them in. And it just seems like it's a really hard time to get them in here.
Well,
they're either not in the area or things like that. You know, we've talked a couple about let's just go ahead and do videos, mm-hmm. Interviews. But, you know,
we do have a couple.
Yeah, we do have a couple that's already booked. Of course, the King of the Keys, Dave Freeman, is going to be
stopping by next week. Next week.
Of course, he's been doing a lot of work in Nashville. So he said, hey, I want to come by. So he said, come on by. So
yeah,
he's going to be here with us next week. And then we also have Gary Burke III scheduled
in May. May 29th.
So
Gary will be in studio.
Yep. And then, like I said, there's been a few others that we've been in talks with. And it's not, they want to come and do the show. It's just trying to pin that date down.
Well, you know, this is tour season.
Yep.
Right
yep.
Now,
so, and there's a couple of them that I know they're trying to get gigs here in Chattanooga. So when they come down and do the show, they will have gigs to do that weekend. So, so hopefully everything will work out and we'll be able to get those artists in there. I know Ashley Estevez, told me that, hey, I want to be there.
And somebody.
And Big Vinny, we already talked to him and he's like, he's in, but again, we just got to find that right date.
And so.
Kitty Stedman.
She messaged back and said she would love to come be on the show.
Nice.
She's going to find a Wednesday evening where she can come and say hey.
All right. Yep, because I talked to Kitty because, you know, a lot of people may or may not know if you haven't been keeping up with it. But Kitty is releasing a solo country music album. So we're excited for that. And that's great. So we'll pin that down. So we'll have Kitty here in the studio for too long. Hopefully get that date pinned
down. She said
as well.
It looks like it might be May.
Awesome.
But yeah.
Awesome. Well, we'll get her pinned down so we can do that as well.
Yep. And Tiki Man said the Trop Rock Cowboy Andrew Dean is going to be live in studio this Sunday on his Sunday morning show.
Oh, very nice. I took this weekend off, this Sunday off.
But Andrew's been hollering at you on Facebook.
I know.
So we might need to go make an appearance.
You did that on purpose, didn't you, Tiki Man? Just because I told him I was going. It's Easter Sunday. I was going to take the day off. I was going to try to be good. I was going to go to church. You know, the two times a year that I, you know, sometimes one time a year that I go.
Right.
And now he's, you know.
Well, we'll just have to go to the early stuff.
You know what they say, temptation comes in all forms.
Now, why would you ever think Tiki Man would be a bad influence?
You do know him, right?
I do.
Uh-huh.
Tiki Man, give Hippie Chick a big hug for me.
All right. Yeah. How about we get some music going here? This one got sent in to us. Philip Wildman, a little moonshine margarita.
First sip, numb my lip, it went down just fine. Second sip, I took a trip back in time to an old tequila margarita, salt, a glass and lime. No tequila margarita, cause she used moonshine. Kentucky bred, I always said she had moonshine in her veins. Her grandpa Bill had a still with copper pipes that clanged as a copper-topped toddler followed every move he made. That's how Margarita got her name. Moonshine Margarita, they don't get no sweeter in the moonshine. A moonshine margarita brings back those memories. I went searching for those bright lights. I had dreams to fulfill, but my thoughts never wandered from those bluegrass hills. I gotta find Margarita, if she's still at that still, and tell her I love her and promise I always will. Now she wants romance and a dance. She loves my company. Moonshine trance, barefoot prance, cute as she can be. She says we're jigging with a hop and 1, 2, 3. Oh, Lord, that's a two-step for me. Moonshine, margarita, they don't come no sweeter. In the moonshine, a moonshine margarita brings back those memories. Oh, she brings back those memories.
Howdy, this is Alex, our little Buddha. On Wednesday nights from 7 to 9, me and Old Silver like to ride into the sunset, listening to B-Dawg and Lou on Tropical Country, only on Tiki Man Radio.
Yeah!
Hey, y'all, this is B-Dawg.
And Lou.
From Tropical Country, B-Dawg and Lou, here to tell you about our sponsor, JBL Legends Travel.
JBL Legends Travel is your full-service travel agent. They specialize in cruises, all-inclusive resort vacations, destination weddings, and romantic getaways. They're dedicated to offering you the best prices and advice, all while maintaining an emphasis on customer service.
So don't hesitate to contact them so they can start planning your next travel adventure. You can contact them at 732-831-5200 or check them out online at jbltravelgroup.net.
Mom needs rest. We need a vacation. Daddy's stressed.
Just a crazy bunch of people who really love the sand. Our toes in the water and a drink in our hand. We love to shake our tail feathers all night long to a tropical band playing favorite songs. So we get together every chance we get. It's the pirate life that we love the most. Rum runners running up and down the coast. When time gets lost, sail Captain Morgan and a hurricane. Wherever we go, wherever we are, we party with a purpose underneath the stars. We're living free, loving life. Yeah, it's a hell of a time. We're parrot heads in paradise. Well, it's a full-time party, drop rocking all year round. We flock from coast and town to town. It's a guaranteed good time we wouldn't trade. Wouldn't take a pot of gold for the friends we made. Soaring together, flying high. Yeah, cause it's a pirate life that we love the most. Rum runners running up and down the coast. When time gets lost, plans ain't made. We sail Captain Morgan and a hurricane. Wherever we go, wherever we are, with a purpose underneath the stars. We're living free.
Dad's in Paradise, Mr. Darby Leadbutter.
Have I mentioned that I love him?
You love Darby, which, of course, we got the Panama City Parrothead rendezvous coming up here very, very soon.
Yes, I cannot wait. That is always my, one of my top things to do every year now. And since Tiki Man and Hippie Chick took us that first year.
You were hooked.
I've been hooked, yeah. So,
which, of course, is the only event we get to go to.
Well, this year, I mean, we got to go to Key West once and some other things.
That one time when I went to Key West.
That one time. And then, you know, we've done some live broadcasts and things like that at other events. But, yeah, I love the Parrothead Rendezvous. It's so much fun. And I'm so excited this year that Darby gets to play on the stage up there. So
that's going to be a blast.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we're staying with Darby and Kathy. Which makes it even better. So, sorry, Tiki.
Right. We get to sleep in the trophy room.
That's right. Listen, last year, so y'all might remember last year whenever we went in there, they showed us our room, and I looked up, and I'm like, is that a real one? And it was Darby's Emmy just sitting there on the shelf, like, just like it was no big deal. So I asked him if I could hold it. And he let me hold his Emmy and everything.
Yeah.
I felt so special. Well, Michelle Myers is out there.
It's not every day you get to hold an Emmy.
Right.
Well, hello to Michelle and also the bodyguard.
Nice to see you. And Tiki Man has given me a really hard time.
Why?
Because apparently Andrew Dean, who we already know and like, right?
Yeah.
Well, I haven't met him in person, but I like him.
I've met him in person, and we've played his music here on the show.
Yes. Apparently, he's bringing another guy with him.
Uh-huh.
Mr. Bowduke himself.
What?
John Schneider.
What?
Yes.
What? Bowduke himself?
Yeah. Yeah, so.
Wow.
Listen, I'm having a hot flash now. Tiki Man says, you go ahead and sleep in. No worries.
We'll be there.
Yeah.
We'll be there.
He said no because we have to go to church. And I told him that's okay. If there's an 8 a.m. service, we can do both.
That's right.
It'll be fine. I know, Michelle, right?
I just got to pray for forgiveness. That's all. But I think it's Bo Duke. I think we'll understand.
Right.
Which, of course, he's quite the musician himself.
He really is.
He's got albums out. Matter of fact, we've played a couple of his songs here on the show, too.
For a long time. And
yeah, and he's been traveling out with another friend of ours, Cody McCarver.
Yeah. So, and they do a lot of stuff together. He's recorded up there at the studio in Dunlap. And so, yeah. And John most recently, you know, lost his wife a few months ago.
Yeah.
So he's still kind of wrestling with that. Mm-hmm. But John did the Masked Singer.
Yeah.
And I was really shocked whenever I saw that. Y'all know how much we love that. Also want to give a shout out to Tracy Bowman.
That would be my cousin.
And then Mr. Mark Mulch is out there tonight.
Hey, Mark.
Michelle said she might have to come up this weekend. Listen, I'm telling you, you don't even understand. But anyways.
Hey, Mark, we need to set a date, a time, a weekend that you're going to be available and I can come up there and, you know, we can chat and we can work on some things.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you guys got some work to do.
We
for
do.
Sure.
We do. So, yeah, just let me know whenever what's your schedule looking like, because I know you're a lot busier than probably I am.
Well, you know, it's getting to be tour season again, and he's got his farmer's markets that he does as well. That's coming up in, May?
Yeah, there's a lot of things that are coming up.
So, Tiki Man, Larissa, the guest room is ready, Michelle. Tiki Man's like, oh, no, you guys go hunt eggs in the hood and go to church. I can handle it. Listen, Tiki Man.
Well, you know.
Boss, you know, I love you.
You know, for the man who says he really doesn't like country music.
Anyhow.
You're doing a pretty good job of getting country music people in that studio over there. That's all I'm saying.
And I, listen, as long as I get to go get a picture, I don't care.
Me neither. You know, because, you know, we have been known to be opportunists and mooches. So, you know.
Right.
So we may have to just do it one more time.
Well, hey, Joe Leo.
Hey, Joe. Of course, that's Joe Leo, JBL Travel Group. And, of course, coming up here shortly, we got a brand new JBL Travel Moment all about all-inclusive resorts.
Yeah. And Mr. I call him Joe Legend and Sue Leo.
Hello to Sue.
They were just named
another award.
Yep. So they were just named the 2024 Florida Sunshine Ambassadors. So in a few weeks, they're going to be broadcasting live from Fort Lauderdale, talking all about Florida and why it's a great place for pre- and post-cruise vacations.
Congratulations, Joe. Well deserved.
Yes. So the 2024 Florida Sunshine Ambassadors, named so by Travel Weekly magazine.
Of course. And if we have said it once, we'll say it again. When you're booking a vacation, trust a professional. Call Joe Leo, 732-831-5200. It doesn't cost you anymore, so why wouldn't you?
That's right. Just love those two. They're the sweetest folks ever. Sorry, I'm still in the chat over here.
I'll wait.
Well, you know, I just had this. Okay, so I don't know if any of y'all ever watched Ally McBeal.
No.
When that was back in the day.
No.
With Calista Flockhart, which, no. On a side note, is married to Indiana Jones himself. But
anyway, Mr. Harrison Ford?
Yes. Anyway, so Ally McBeal used to have these moments where they would be sitting there. She would be standing there and somebody would be talking to her and she would just like zone out and go into another whole scenario of what she wanted to say or do, but couldn't. And then she would come back to herself and say what she actually was like, what was acceptable to say. Right.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I have those Ally McBeal moments a lot. And so I just had one when I was looking at the chat in Tiki Man. And I had this whole vision of me sitting at the chocolate bar with John Schneider standing there and Tiki Man making some really inappropriate comment about how excited I am that he's going to be there. So, Tiki Man, if you're listening, stay sober so that you don't embarrass me on Sunday. Because I know you'd be like, oh, here's Lou. She had to do all kinds of stuff to come see you.
Yeah, he would do everything he could to embarrass the living heck out of
me. I know. Hey, Golden Girl, it's okay. We don't mind that you're...
Hello to Claudia and the Golden Boy. Golden himself.
The Golden Boy?
The Golden Boy.
So, Claudia, just scroll up and read a little bit at what Tiki Man said.
I have a feeling the chocolate bar is going to be packed.
Listen.
On Easter.
Listen, I love y'all, but y'all stay away. Just saying. No, I'm just kidding. Reef rum will be ready. Sweet. I can try that, too.
There you go.
And then I won't care if he embarrasses me.
You can't get drunk around John Schneider.
Listen. Listen, that reminds me.
Let's just say, you know, that is like a bucket list thing. It really is.
Honestly, yeah.
So for me, it's always been because 2 years ago, you actually took me down to Georgia and took me to all the scenes where they actually filmed the Dukes of Hazzard.
Yes.
And where the original Boar's Nest was, where they did
the
the courthouse and all that. So I've been a big Dukes of Hazzard fan, and that's always been, you know, on my bucket list, and you know, never thought I would ever have an opportunity, but this is pretty cool.
I know, right?
Yeah. He knows how to get me.
He does.
You get me, don't you? You just get me.
He had to do something to make sure you're there.
Oh,
he loves you.
Yeah, he's like, you know, he could have mentioned that last Sunday while we were on the air. You know, I'm going to let him stew on it. Then I'm really going to make him feel bad. You know, like, I'm really going to stick it in his heart.
Yeah. He knew we would show up for that.
He did.
So, speaking of getting drunk in front of your crush, a few years ago, well, a lot of years ago now, I had a high school reunion.
Mm-hmm.
It was our 10-year reunion. No, 5-year reunion, maybe.
You actually went to those?
I went to one.
I haven't been to a single reunion.
I went to one. And I went, and the guy that I dated all the way through high school.
Gary.
So he was there.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
With his new wife, right? Who everybody said looked like me, by the way. So anyways. So.
Not conceited at all.
No. Well, I was looking in, you know, you got to write these little program things. And I was looking in there, and he had written something about her being the love of his life.
Aww.
Well, you know that's what I always said about him, right? So, he wasn't, but whatever.
Yeah, she's making me feel real good over here.
No, I'm saying I said that because you were there for it.
That is true, but, you know, because everybody assumed that her and Gary would always be together. I mean, like, when they broke up, nobody ever asked her out because everybody just assumed that her and Gary would get back together again.
And we usually did.
And you usually did.
Until...
You didn't.
We didn't. But anyway, so when I saw that he wrote, she was a love of her, not that I hold on to things for a long time or anything, but then I started drinking because I was going to behave because he was going to be there and he does not drink. And so I saw that, I started drinking. I was like, well, screw it. So started drinking. Don't you know, apparently by the time that Gary and I walked up to each other to say hi, I was wasted. And I did not know until one of my friends told me later that apparently I leaned in about 4 inches from his face and was just like, how have you been?
And he's thinking, man, I dodged a bullet
right?
there.
He probably really was.
You know, really thank was. God for unanswered prayers.
Exactly. Exactly. So that was another Allie McBeal moment. I was thinking about me standing there with John Schneider, just drunk off my butt, trying to have a conversation.
Yeah, I will pull you out of there for on another note. Hey, we got another JBL Legends Travel moment coming up next.
White sand between my toes, cold beer and a radio. Like the waves that are rolling in, here comes her memory crashing down again. Takes me back to her favorite song, in the way that she sang along. And try to figure out what went wrong. I miss that fire felt in her kiss, like the sun beating down, burning up my skin. Palm tree swaying in the wind, got me thinking how she hit me like a hurricane spinner. And the melody that keeps haunting me, every time I turn it on, got it stuck on repeat. Yeah, she was the one, there'll never be another. She was my song of the summer. Can't forget the look in her eyes. We were just out of reach of the hotel lights, but I still see every tan line, and it's hitting me hard tonight. I miss that fire felt in her kiss, like the sun beating down, burning up my skin. Palm tree swaying in the wind, got me thinking how she hit me like a hurricane spinner. Name's a melody that keeps haunting me. Every time I turn it on, got it stuck on repeat, yeah. She was the one, there'll never be another. She was my song of summer. Now she's gone, but I still feel the sting. July won't let me forget. She was my everything. I miss that fire I felt in her kiss, like the sun beating down, burning up my skin. Palm tree swaying in the wind, got me thinking how she hit me like a hurricane spinner. Name's a melody that keeps haunting me. Every time I turn it on, got it stuck on repeat, yeah. She was the one, there'll never be another.
she was my song of the summer. She was my song of the summer. Yeah, her memory has got a hold of me. She was my song of the summer.
And now, Tiki Man Radio is proud to present the JBL Legends Travel Moment with Joe Leo. Take it away, Joe.
Good morning, everybody. It's Joe Leo with the JBL Travel Group with this week's Travel Minute. And this week I want to talk about all-inclusive resorts and how all-inclusive resorts are not created equal. How's that for a mouthful? So I had a lady call me this week, and she said, you know, I want to take my family on an all-inclusive resort, and, you know, I'm open to anything, but there's a lot of variations. So let me just talk a little bit about them. All-inclusive resorts are not all the same. First of all, the word all-inclusive implies that everything is included, you know, like your meals and drinks and stuff, but there are very significant variations among the different resorts on what's included. So let's just go over some of the things. So some of the resorts charge extra for some of their select specialty restaurants. Some of the resorts charge extra for tours, activities, spa activities, premium alcohol packages. So while others include those, and like a sandals, or as verse 2a, sandals and beaches. So some of those things are included in that. So it depends upon really where your budget is. So choosing the right resort is always a challenge when you're dealing with the client or you're thinking about it, because resorts cater to different crowds. So and different demographic groups. Some of the resorts are a party kind of place, and it's really more for spring breakers. Other resorts are family friendly, and they accommodate the families and the small children. Others are specifically geared to honeymoons and romantic getaways or destination weddings, and those also do, you know, like bachelorette parties and things like that. So that's something to definitely consider. And location is very important. Remember that all-inclusive resorts span, there's hundreds and hundreds of them, and they span the globe from Mexico all the way to the deserts in Dubai. So, you know, while some people like beachfront properties, other people opt to be closer to the mountains and the jungles and sightseeing, and other people want to be closer to the desert. So where do you want to go? That's the difference. And then, of course, timing matters. Traveling during the right season, where you're going to be able to, you know, have the best blue skies and less rain, and it's not hurricane season in that particular area. And then there's the economy, there's the mid-range, and there's the luxury type all-inclusive resorts. So not all-inclusive resorts are not all created equal. So if you're looking for an all-inclusive resort, number one, we need to talk about budget. Where do you want to be price-wise? Number two, what's it for? Is it for your family? Is it just for you? Is it a romantic getaway? Are you planning a honeymoon, a destination wedding? Or are you just looking to go lay on the beach with a couple of your girlfriends and relax and, you know, have a couple of drinks and chill out? So those first two. Number three, destination. Where do you want to go? You want to go to Aruba. You want to go to Mexico, Punta Cana, Dubai, St. Lucia. Where do you want to go? You tell me where you want to go. And what kind of activities do you want to do? Do you want one that has a lot of different types of water sports and those kind of things? And what kind of food options do you want? Are you looking for one that has specialty restaurants that are included? Or you don't care, you just want the buffet and whatever is included and the specialty restaurants don't matter to you? Or you want one with specialty restaurants that you have to pay for? And what kind of food options are there? You know, the food options can vary from resort to resort. While most of them have a buffet and then also have specialty restaurants like Italian, French, Mexican, a steakhouse, a hibachi, something like that. Some of them have that, some of them don't. So what kind of food options are you looking for? And how big of a resort do you want? Do you want something that's kind of small and boutique-ish, or do you want something that's larger? The other thing I always tell people, let's consider what's going on. A lot of times resorts have special offers where the second person is half price, or all water sports are included, motorized water sports are included. So those are the things you need to consider, because all-inclusive resorts are not all created equal. And I try to tell people that when they call me, and narrow that down. So if you're thinking about taking an all-inclusive resort, give me a call. Talk to your travel agent or give me a call, 732-831-5200. Let's talk about everything that encompasses it so that you have a really good vacation. Anyway, this is Joe Leo with the JBL Travel Group. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. Have a great day.
Thanks, Joe. Always travel with someone you trust. JBL Legends Travel and Joe Leo. Reach out to him at 732-831-5200. The official travel company of Tiki Man Radio.
Tough as nails with toes of steel, but they're no good in this island weather, so I went shopping to find me a deal. I tried on loafers, tried on sneakers, I must have tried about 20 pairs of soles. Started feeling like I was Cinderella with that leather in between my toes. With the flip-flop fits,
Mr. Mike Nash.
He's so much fun.
He is. He is a great guy.
He really is.
What are you laughing over there about?
Oh, it was a news article, but you don't want to know.
Probably not.
Yeah, I can't even say it on TV. But
okay.
On TV. On
okay.
Radio. But I will say, I came across some interesting news.
Really?
I did.
Okay.
Let me find it again.
Okay.
All right.
I'll wait.
So, in this lady in Cheshire, England.
Okay.
Was driving down the road, and she looked off on the side of the road, and she saw a baby hedgehog abandoned on the side of the road.
Okay.
So she got a box out of her trunk, and she rescued it like a good human being. The next day, she decided she was going to take it to the vet because it had not pooped.
Okay.
Since she picked it up, and she was concerned.
Right.
So she got to the vet, and she carried it in the box, and asked the vet to take a look at it. And the vet informed her that it was a beanie off the top of a toboggan. It was like the little yarn puff. Honest to God.
What?
Honest to God. The vet did say, in her defense, though, she did not touch it because she didn't know how to handle a hedgehog. So she just scooped it up with the box. And
well, let me tell you something. My daughter owned two hedgehogs. And never once would you would ever mistake a beanie for a hedgehog. They look vastly different, including one has a face.
Right. She just thought it was curled up in a ball.
Still.
She was concerned.
Still, you can tell the difference between a hedgehog and the little puffy thing on the top of a beanie. They don't look even remotely the same. My question is, what was she drinking?
Well, it said she was an older lady.
Okay.
Which, I'm like, listen, she was an older lady, maybe 60s or 70s. That's not old enough to be mistaken.
Not anymore.
Yeah, but she did. But she was trying to be a good human.
Mm-hmm.
Just saying. And the other breaking news. The Cadbury Bunny.
Uh-huh.
You know, every year, Cadbury does a contest.
It's usually a bunny that sounds like a chicken.
Yes, yes. Well, this year, the company has announced that the Cadbury Bunny is Louie the Raccoon.
The Cadbury Bunny is not a bunny.
No, it's Louie the Raccoon.
Louie the Raccoon. Okay.
He has little, if y'all could see the picture, it's so cute, but he has little bunny ears on.
Oh, I'm sure they'll get to see it real on their TVs really soon.
Well, it says that an Easter tradition is the Cadbury Bunny tryouts commercial.
Uh-huh.
And Louie will be in that commercial next year.
Next year.
Next year. So Louie apparently
beat out the rabbit
and the chicken.
And the chicken that did the voiceover work.
Yes. Louie is a 2-year-old from Miami, Florida, and he was the winner of the 6th annual Cadbury Bunny tryouts and will have a role in the 2025 Cadbury Bunny tryouts commercial, which is an Easter tradition. Louie's owner rescued him in 2021 when he was deemed unfit to live in the wild. So, the raccoon won the hearts of voters on Instagram with his friendly face and his special skill, which is creating paintings to be sold to benefit wildlife rescue and rehab centers.
Oh, so that's what it is. So, this raccoon had a social media following.
He had a social media following. It all goes back to social media.
See the importance of a social media following?
Right.
And it would be great if you didn't get labeled a spammer.
Right.
You know, it would be a great tool for advertising. Can you imagine that? Advertising on social media. It's an amazing thing.
Right.
Unless you're a spammer like
just
me.
Just ask Lou the raccoon. Yeah, so this raccoon apparently is not only cute, but he's talented, and he knows how to paint.
Alrighty then.
So he is, Louie the raccoon is the new Cadbury Bunny.
All right.
For next year. Hey, Josh Clark is out there.
Hey,
aren't
Josh.
Aren't you glad you joined us now?
Hey, I got some borderline entertainment news.
Okay.
For those of you that come from our generation, you know, the Gen Xers, you remember back in the day, like, oh, I'm going to say like 1985, somewhere around in there, you know, a big hit movie like, you know, with Kevin Bacon, you know, called Footloose.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah.
Well, do you know that the high school where they filmed Footloose, they're getting ready to tear it down.
That's right. They
got to build a whole brand new high school, beautiful new high school. And the senior class there, you know, they wanted to have their prom in the old high school for, you know, send off the old building.
Right.
Well, since that building was used when they filmed Footloose, they started a social media campaign to try to get Kevin Bacon to come to their prom. And they were to the point of, you know, it was all over social media to the point where national news picked it up and all of that. And then finally, it was one of like, I think the Today Show or something like that. You know, they were live with the kids at their high school and everything. And they said, well, you know, we have a surprise for you. Well, Kevin came up on the screen, laughed and said, I've seen all your social media campaigns. And he goes, you know, he goes, I think it's cool that you want to send the school out like that. So he's like, yeah, I'll come.
Oh my gosh, how fun.
So then, of course, he finished it off. He's like, let's dance. So Kevin Bacon's going to go down there to the high school and spend prom with those kids for the final night in that high school.
Oh, how fun.
So I thought that was some nice entertainment news because you hear so much negativity about celebrities, especially lately. That right. I thought it was a nice upbeat thing and a nice thing for him to do.
That is really cool. I don't know if you've seen, speaking of social media, I don't know, have you been watching his social media at all?
Kevin Bacon's?
Yeah.
I've seen him cooking with his wife, and I've seen him do a lot of different things.
Well, he apparently lives on a farm with a bunch of goats.
Yes, they definitely did.
You know, he plays in a band.
Uh-huh.
And so he'll go out there in the... He'll go out there with his guitar and sit in the barn and with the goats. And the last one I saw, he was right in the middle of the song and one of the goats ate his hat, took it off his head. So the goats are more entertaining than Kevin, I'm not going to lie. But yeah, so they have a lot of fun. And I love his wife, Mom.
Your mom loved that the show that
Closer.
She... Closer. The Closer. Is that, yeah. Yeah, that's what she was on.
Yeah, she was on The Closer and... I did not realize that they were married until I think after The Closer went off the air.
Yeah, I never knew who he was married to.
And she sings as well. So sometimes they'll do TikToks where she's singing with him and stuff like that. So, yeah, they're a lot of fun. What is her name? Kira Sedgwick?
Kira Sedgwick, yeah. Yeah. Your mom loved her.
Yeah, yeah, I do too. She's fun. All right, I'll wait until after you play some music for this one.
Okay.
Because I have some headlines.
Uh-oh.
And I may or may not be going to hell for one of them.
Uh-oh. Well, you know, I don't know. All right. Hey, let's go back to a little bit. Put our minds in 1985, getting ready for the prom. Let's go dance!
Gotta cut loose, foot loose, kick off. rock your Sunday shoes. Please, Louise, pull me off of my knees. Jack, get back, come on before we crack. Lose your boots, everybody cut for loose. You're playing so cool, obeying every rule. Cut loose, footloose, kick off your Sunday shoes. Ooh-wee, Marie, shake it for me. Whoa, Milo, come on, let's go. Loose your blues, everybody cut for
into the sunset, listening to B-Dawg and Lou on Tropical Country, only on Tiki Man Radio.
It was the last long days of summer, autumn in the air. You and me, we must agree, made an unlikely pair. Down there by the ocean, on a blanket with a bottle of wine. I know I don't tell you often enough, but after all this time, you are always on the beaches of my mind. In a mad, mad world where love's so hard to find, I can see your hair blowing in the wind. Forever young, sun-kissed skin. You're always on the beaches of my mind. You're on the beaches of my mind. Somehow you manage to love me in spite of my rowdy ways. Well, to tell the truth, what's more my suit is loving you these days. Down there on the island, dancing our nights away. And if I get caught up in too much stuff, don't let me forget to say that you're always on the beaches of my mind. In a mad, mad world where love's so hard to find. Well, I can see your hair blowing in the wind. Forever young, sun-kissed skin. You're always on the beaches of my mind. why don't we just sail away? Why put off till tomorrow love we can make today? You're always on the beaches of my mind. In a mad, mad world where love's so hard to find. Yeah, you're always on the beaches of my mind. In this mad, mad world where love's so hard to find. Oh, I can see your hair blowing in the wind. Forever young, sun-kissed skin. You're always on the beaches of my mind. You're always on the beaches of my mind. You're always on the beaches of my mind. You're on the beaches of my mind.
Hey y'all, this is B-Dawg
and Lou
from Tropical Country right here on Tiki Man Radio. Next time you take a trip down to the Key West and you want to get out on the water, we want you to check out our sponsor, Goaltending Services. Goaltending Services is the premier charter service in Key West. They offer a wide range of amenities. Goaltending Services is also a veteran-owned company, and they take care of their veterans and active duty personnel by offering a 25% discount with your veteran or military ID. For more about Goaltending Services, give them a call at 305-916-0990.
Or look them up online at goaltendingservices.com.
Off the coast on a boat, tribal rock on the radio.
That's right. Check out Goaltending Services, GTS Charters down in Key West, Florida. All right, what you got over there?
I've got...
Hold on there. There you go.
I've got some crazy headlines.
All right.
I may or may not be going to hell. Because this first one, I did not write it, but I thought it was hysterical.
All right.
One-armed man applauds his rescuers.
Okay. Well, you can do that.
Yes.
You don't need two arms to applaud.
Okay. Headless body in topless bar.
Now, are these
actual headlines?
These aren't like bad dad jokes.
No, these are honest. Headless body in topless bar was on the New York Post.
All right.
Just saying.
Almost needs like more explanation as to. To what, whom, what, when, where, and why?
There's a lot of them. Here's one from, I guess this is not from this baseball season, obviously, but A-Rod goes deep, Wang hurt.
Uh-huh.
Just saying.
Hold on.
I didn't write them. Just saying. The Los Angeles Times.
Uh-huh.
Big rig carrying fruit crashes on 210 freeway creates jam. Marijuana issue sent to a joint committee. And two more. Woman missing since she got lost.
That doesn't even deserve anything right there.
And scientists to kill ducks to see why they're dying.
Why are we killing ducks? Come on.
To see why they're dying.
That is stupid.
So, I'm just saying. So those are some of the headlines.
Stupid.
Listen, again, I don't write them.
All right. Does anybody actually got anything intelligent to say out there? In the chat,
that was mean.
I'm not saying that it's the writers, you know. mm-hmm. some of these stories that either they're really interesting stories or they really need to learn how to proofread. And I'm thinking that's the latter is probably what it is.
You would think. Uh-huh. There was another one that I'm not even going to say it, but.
Good.
Yeah. There was. Good. There's some that are bad.
Okay.
I won't say them, though.
Good. Moving on.
Michelle.
Y'all right over there?
Maybe. I didn't write it, Michelle. Michelle did the screaming Lou.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, Moni, you might need to reset or, like, fast forward.
What?
Moni walked away for a few minutes, uh-huh. and now YouTube makes it like we're an hour behind. So, but yeah, YouTube might have reset for whatever reason, Moni.
Did she pause? Because here's the thing. If you put us on pause, guess we're live. So the show continues. So when you come back and hit play, the show is picking up where you left off and not where we are live. So if you want to catch up to us live, then you got to scroll your little marker all the way down to the end until live pops up.
Right.
So because.
Well, she said she did not pause. Hmm. So.
Well, I didn't do nothing. It ain't on me. I've touched a setting. They've all been the same. So, I went through everything with a fine tooth comb this week.
Right.
Trust me.
You really did.
I did.
So, you know, we're at the end of the month, mm-hmm. but because we're at the end of the month, until the end of this month, the Grand Ole Opry is doing buy one, get one free tickets.
No.
Just for the last few days of this month.
Oh, just the last few days.
Yeah, yeah. No. For the shows that are going on.
So they're not sold out, so they're needing to sell out the house.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, who's performing in the next few days? Not that we're able to go, but
right.
in case somebody is around Nashville and goes, hey, I want to go to the Opry. If they're doing reduced ticket pricing, that may be a good thing to know.
They really are. All right. What? This is this is March, right?
Yes.
All right. So. Well, that was tonight. Never mind. Hold on. Tomorrow night. They are doing country classics at the Opry House.
Mm-hmm.
Rhett Akins, Crystal Gayle, Louise Mandrell.
Oh, Louise.
I know. The Gatlin Brothers and Sonny Sweeney.
Oh, very cool.
So, yeah, that's tomorrow night.
With Sonny Sweeney. She's a newer singer, but she has that old vibe, old
she
sound.
Does.
Yeah,
I like her a lot. And then... Let me see. Friday night
mm-hmm.
is Stephen Curtis Chapman. He's a Christian singer, gospel singer.
Uh-huh.
Meg McCree.
Meg McCree. I've heard of her. Yeah.
Riders in the Sky.
Oh, okay.
Connie Smith. Daly and Vincent. Zach Topp and Clay Walker.
Oh, let me tell you what. Well, I love Clay Walker, but Zach Topp, he's a new artist that's out there. But close your eyes when you hear him sing. Just close your eyes. Not that he's not a nice looking guy, but he is straight up 90s country.
Oh,
he
yeah.
sounds like 90s
is that the
country.
Guy that you played for me this week?
I've played him on the show a couple different times, and yeah, he straight up sounds like 90s country. And again, he's a new artist. I'm going to tell you what, I've been listening to a lot of music lately. You know, a bunch of different genres, obviously, for the business. But I was paying attention to a lot of the new country music that's coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And when I tell you, you know, country music has, you know, I used to stick up for a lot of things in country music. But it's definitely where country music has now branched off into, there's no doubt in my mind now, it's broken off into subgenres.
Oh, yeah.
There's just no ifs, ands, or buts.
Than ever.
Yeah. I listened to and I played it for you last night. A country song that came out.
Yeah.
And listening to, you know, I'm sorry, but you can't do a 90s boys to men song and just put words like girls, cowboy boots, boots, pickup trucks, and hats, and it automatically becomes country.
I mean, it was the most, and I know that there have been country artists that did boys to men or vice versa.
Yeah.
But this sounded straight up R&B.
There was nothing country
about
it.
It was beautiful. Mm-hmm. It was beautiful. Nothing country about it, except the word pickup trucks and cowboy hats and boots in the song.
Girls and cowboy boots. Yeah. Yeah. So it's definitely, country music is definitely, yeah, it's broken off. There are so many subgenres now. It's hard, you know, when you say country music ain't country no more, you just got to say, you got to look for your favorite subgenre that you like. If you like the classic country, you know, like the old, those, that's one way you go with it that way.
Yeah.
You like the 90s country, you go that way. There are a lot of new artists out there that are putting out great music that is, you know, like I said, you listen to it, you swear it was recorded in the 90s. It's not remakes of songs, it is new songs. But they just,
in the 90s,
they just have that 90s country sound.
And then you have some young kids
and you got
that
some,
are doing the old.
You got the Red Dirt coming, and I heard a new one that came out from an artist that literally sounds like something like in the 1960s, like where, you know, Hank Sr. It sounded like that.
Yep.
Old style of country, and you know, and this guy's a new guy. So, and there's a lot of guys out there. You know, Tyler Booth. We talk about Tyler again. We're still working on getting him in here. He's one of those young guys that grew up on the old style country, and his mission is to bring that old style country back.
Yeah,
which there is a whole subgenre for that, but. But some of the country music that's coming out right now, you know, if you're a country music purist, you're like, I don't like it. If you are that person who says, I hate country music, you come check out country music again.
Some of the new country.
Because country music has something for everybody now.
Yeah.
I did listen to the Beyonce country song.
Which one? She's done two now, apparently.
Well, Texas Hold'em. I listened to Texas Hold'em.
Listen,
and
I have to admit something.
I'm going to tell you one thing.
What?
It'll be one hell of a line dance song.
I gave Beyonce, I do not that I know her personally, but I'm not a big Beyonce fan.
Mm-hmm. But
song, I finally did break down and listen. I kind of didn't have a choice because it was all over TikTok. And it's not bad.
It didn't, but it's a line dance song.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And she now put out, I saw today, she has put out kind of a poster teaser of her album, the country album that she's doing. And Willie Nelson,
mm-hmm.
Dolly Parton.
There are a lot of people on this are supporting her.
That are supporting her and that are on this album.
Mm-hmm.
Either them or they've given permission for their songs. So that's really when I'm going to have... I've been told, or at least it mentioned in this article, that she has recorded Jolene, which
a lot of people,
keep doing that same song.
Yeah, a lot of people have done Jolene,
and so I'm gonna reserve judgment until I see how she handles some of the classics, and then we'll see how, you know.
Yeah,
But that song is catchy. Yeah. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, once I said, and you know, I actually listened to it and I heard it and you know, I had it kicking on the stereo and I'm like, yeah. Yeah, I can, this would definitely be in the country line dance genre. then of course, you know, going through TikTok, what do I come across? Country line dancers line dancing that song. They've already made a dance up to it.
Oh yeah.
So, it is taking off. So Who knows? It went number one. Yeah.
It went number one, and she became...
That's because of all the Beyonce fans running out and buying it, which, of course, you know, since it was released on a country, you know,
label,
label that That's why it went to number one. But she is not number one no more. She's been taken over.
Good. Who is it now?
I can't remember.
I don't know.
Well, she actually was unseated by Toby Keith, actually, because Toby's music started climbing back up the charts again. So she actually was unseated for a couple weeks from Don't Let the Old Man In. And then,
that's right.
And then, of course, once Toby was nominated and got into the Country Music Hall of Fame, he finally got the nod.
Yes.
How Do You Like Me Now all of a sudden shot up.
I love
that. And became number one on the country charts again. Because, of course, you know, he made it in. And there, you know, he didn't get that sympathy vote. He literally got in on his merits because the voting for that ended 3 days before his passing. So he did make it in on his merits.
Yeah, I thought that was really interesting. Michelle, you didn't like the song? Yeah. The song's catchy, but the Texas Hold'em song.
Yeah.
I don't know about the other one. I just can't support her. But anyway, refresh my memory because I did squirrel.
Don't do what you.
You don't know either, do you? What we were talking about.
Listen.
Hey, Verona.
She.
What?
She's asking the guy with ADD. Hey, do you remember what I was talking about? Nope. I had something else on my mind.
I know. Well, Verona Corona's out there. She just rescued me.
Hey, Verona.
No worries, Verona. She just got out of the pool.
Okay.
I know.
You know, I've been doing a lot of, lately been looking at, thinking about jobs and, the starting this business and careers and all of that. And I always say, I had dream jobs and everything. And, I was wondering, what would the absolute dream job be? If you really think about it, I guess it'd be different for everybody else.
Oh, yeah.
But, Blaine Larson has an answer for what he thinks the perfect job is. He wants to be that guy at the resorts, standing there holding the towel for the ladies when they get out of the pool. Yes, sirree, Bob! Here's Blaine Larson.
Just watching TV, flipping through the channels, and what do I see? A swimsuit model on the Cozumel sand, and some lucky guy with a towel in his hand. Pulling it up as she changes her suit, getting all the best shots at the photo shoot. How do you get that job? That's what I want to know. Wherever he went to school, that's where I want to go. Holding up that towel, he's got it all figured out. Yes, sirree, Bob, how hard could it be? That's the life for me. How do you get that job? Well, there's doctors and lawyers with PhDs who spend half their lives just to get their degrees. Pro ball players we can all name who spend every waking hour trying to master the game. Then there's a guy with no talent by the girl with no clothes on the beach by the ocean in Mexico. How do you get that job? That's what I want to know. Wherever he went to school, that's where I want to go. Holding up that towel, how hard could it be? That's the life for me. How do you get that job?
So Jack, you gotta tell me, what do you talk about when they're changing?
Oh, the usual, Blaine. Quantum physics, foreign policy.
Yeah, that's great. Do you ever sneak a look over the towel?
You want the truth, Blaine? You can't handle the truth.
How do you get that job? That's what I want. He went to school.
job. Hey, that's the life for me. Yes, sirree, Bob.
How do you get that job?
Mo, listening in from North Carolina to Tropical Country with B-Dawg and Lou on Tiki Man Radio. Wednesday evening, 7 to 9.
It's gearing up for the 8th annual Tiki Man Radio Songwriter Showcase QS Bound. October 31st through November the 2nd at the Rick's Dirty Harry's Complex on Duval Street in Key West, Florida. All the artists are booked and locked and ready to go. And of course, our event is free to the public. Everybody is a VIP. This year, of course, we're bringing back the SAC Awards, sponsored by Tiki Man Radio and presented by Tim Campbell. And new this year is the Jimmy Buffett Look-A-Lock Contest, brought to you by Landshark Lager. That's right, come dressed as your favorite era of Jimmy Buffett and win a special prize by Landshark Beer. That's going to be on Friday night, right after Dave McKinney and the Hungry Heart Luck Heroes Band plays. And of course, we're going to honor our friend Bill Crawley. Make sure you come by the Tiki Man Radio table and pick up your fan's fan of Bill Crawley. I want to see a lot of pictures. We want to make this special. Bill Crawley played at every event we had, and we want to make sure that we honor our good friend. That's the 8th annual Tiki Man Radio Songwriter Showcase Key West Bound. The original Songwriter Showcase during Trop Rock Week, October 31st through November the 2nd at Rick's Dirty Harry's on Duval Street in Key West, Florida. Why would you go anywhere else? Here's your weekly lineup for Tiki Man Radio. Sundays, it's the big show. Sunday mornings with the Tiki Man starting at 10 a.m. Eastern Island Time. Streaming live on the Island J Live Cam from the Chocolate Bar Studios in Harrison Bay. Come over and be part of the show. After the big show, it's Tuesday on the Island Replay with B-Man and Michelle, recorded live from Key West. Later that afternoon, it's 5 o'clock somewhere with Rick the Stick. You never know where he's going to pop up. On the Road with Rick the Stick, starting at 5 p.m. Eastern Island Time every Sunday. Mondays from 6 to 8 p.m., get on the Peace Train with Ed the Train Man, live from Crown Point, Indiana. Tuesday at noon, it's Surfs Up with Callie McCool and the student crew. Tiki Man Radio's internship from Antioch High School in California. The kids are learning how to produce and do their own show. Compliments of Tiki Man Radio. It's the Lunchbox Special with Surfs Up every Tuesday at noon, Eastern Island Time. Wednesdays, it's where the boots meet the beach with Tropical Country with B-Dawg and Lou. Streaming live on the MFG Tropical Live Cam from the Chocolate Bar Studios from 7 to 9 p.m. Make sure you catch the Friday kickoff with Jen Shen from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. every Friday. Jen kicks off the weekend and tells you all the activities coming up on Tiki Man Radio and spotlights all of our sponsors. That's the Friday kickoff with Jen Shen every Friday from 11 to 1 p.m. You don't want to miss it. Friday, starting at 8 p.m., it's Coastal Confessions with B-Man and Michelle from the Beachy Shell Studios in Key West, live every Friday, having some fun with their friends and sharing great music. Saturdays, take a trip back in time with Jukebox Saturday Mornings, starting at midnight and going to noon. This is where we open up the massive archives of the radio station and take you back to that old shaggin' music. That's your weekly lineup for Tiki Man Radio. Make sure you tune into all these great shows and keep listening to Tiki Man Radio and have some fun.
That's right. Of course, a programming note is there is no B-Man and Michelle this week because they're still out on their sailing trip.
Yes.
They are having a great time.
Yes, if you've seen their pictures, they're beautiful. They look like they're having a blast.
Well, how could you not?
Right? Well, that the song that you played, not the last song, but the one that started this last segment, that was Blaine Larson, right?
Yes, Blaine Larson.
So I was talking to Greasy Joe. He was messaging me the other day. He's working on some more new music. So
awesome.
Excited about that.
We need to get him back here.
We do. And one of the folks that he's working with is Blaine Larson.
You don't say.
And he said Blaine is a really good friend of his, super nice guy. And for those of you who don't remember Blaine, or who need to feel old, I did. At 15 years old, Blaine had a song out. Back in 2004, called How Do You Get That Lonely?
Yes,
and
yes.
If you remember the video, he was driving in a pickup truck, Mm-hmm. And the song is a really, really sad song, but it really struck a chord with a lot of people. And apparently, you know, Blaine went on, he did some more things, but then as he got older, of course, you know, as sadly happens with a lot of the younger people, once they start to grow up, mm-hmm. folks lose interest. And so, according to Greasy Joe, Blaine is now back into writing some more, going to be mm-hmm. recording some new music and things like that.
So, we need to get Joe and Blaine in here.
Yeah. So I did message Joe and said, hey, y'all need to get up here mm-hmm. back to Tennessee. So
absolutely.
But yeah, so Blaine, if you don't remember him, look him up. He was super mm-hmm. talented. And that song that you played is so much fun.
Of course, I heard that and I'm like, yeah, that would be the dream job. Just stand by the pool and go, excuse me, ma'am, I have your towel.
Right? Yeah, you would be in heaven. Oh, yeah, Verona, do not throw your phone in the pool.
She's already had enough phone issues.
I know. Well, she said the phone that she has now on the screen froze up, so she was mad. She's like, I'm ready to throw it in the pool. I'm like, listen, be careful what you wish for.
Mm-hmm.
Just went through that. But yeah. So I'm excited to hear what Blaine's going to do. And Greasy Joe as well. He sent us a song to listen to, which every once in a while I'm really honored because he'll reach out and say, hey, I'm working on this song. You should take a listen.
And, you know, it's really tempting, though, because if he sends a song, lets us hear it.
And then we're not allowed to play
it. And then
he
says, but you can't play it yet.
I know. It's like, I know.
Oh, why would you do this to me?
I know. So,
So we know what's coming down the pike for Greasy Joe, let's just say.
Yeah.
And you'd be looking forward
to
it.
It's a good thing.
Yeah.
So that's all I had to say about that.
That's all you got to say about that? Okay, Forrest. Forrest gone.
Forrest.
That's all I got to say about that. Well, you got anything else? We got about 4 minutes to go before we wrap things up for the night. So, any loose ends that you want to wrap up?
No.
What?
I know.
How is that possible?
Well, because I talked a lot tonight.
Yeah, thank goodness. We do a programming note that the King of the Keys, Mr. Dave Freeman, will be here with us next week.
Yes.
Again, he is in Nashville, been doing a bunch of work in there and some writing.
Playing some Bluebird Cafe.
Playing at the Bluebird Cafe. And so.
And I did see an announcement or a post from him today that he has been in the studio with our good friends, MFG Records Tropical, Dave Signs and Beth Travers.
Yes.
Working on some original music.
Very nice.
Yesterday he posted, so I did a thing today with the help of my MFG Records family.
Uh-huh.
We started recording 3 of my original songs.
How awesome is
each
that?
Each to be released individually as Trop Rock singles in the coming months.
Very cool.
So, yeah, he's working with Beth Travers, Alan Jacks Bowers, and Dave Signs.
Well, that's a good group to be working with,
isn't it? I said, that's a whole lot of talent in the room. And Dave's schedule, of course, you know, as usual, is just packed.
He's in high demand.
He is in high demand, and he's...
So are all those, you know, between Dave and Beth and Alan Jacks Bowers, and they are all in high demand.
They are, and Dave, like you said, has been doing a lot of things in Nashville, and he does have some things, let me see. Yeah, he's been in Nashville a lot this month, so I'm really excited he's coming back. When he reached out to us,
absolutely.
I was excited. I told him we're in the new studio, so he may need to bring a stand for his keyboard this time and some extra cords.
And we'll figure out if B-Dawg can get his keyboard hooked up into this board, because, you know, last time we did it, we were over at the, you know, the Chocolate Bar Studios,
yes.
And that was all the Tiki Man. So,
right.
I watched. But we'll have to see what could possibly go wrong with that. I don't know.
It'll be fine.
Sure. Let's see. Since we've been, you know, you want to talk about gremlins. I swear that the gremlins moved from the chocolate bar. Not all of them left because the Tiki Man had issues Sunday.
Right.
Also, so not all the gremlins left, but I think one or two hopped in my back pocket and just came. They're like, studio? Ooh. What? We gotta check that out.
New territory.
New territory. And I tell you what, those gremlins have been doing everything that they could do, you know, just when you think you got things figured out. And no.
Right.
So I got sound figured out. No, you don't. You're watching a Japanese movie. Okay, well, I got that fixed. Okay, I got this fixed. Nope, your sound's hot. Okay, let me get my sound fixed.
Now you know how the boss feels.
Yeah, now your cameras, you look like you're in a sunset. So the gremlins could leave me a hell alone. I'm done with them. I want a divorce from the gremlins.
Right?
I haven't been feeding them or getting them wet, so leave me alone.
Not feeding them after midnight?
That's right.
Listen, that movie was so much fun. I'm going to have to watch that again. You know those, what is it, the Mandela effects?
Yes.
So you know the gremlin, the one that had the mohawk?
Yes.
What was his name?
I don't know.
Anybody out there know what his name? I want to see what y'all remember his name being.
Gizmo?
No, Gizmo was the cute one.
Oh, I don't know.
This one, Verona's got gremlins in her phone tonight. Okay, so, you know, there was the mean one that I always called him Spike.
I thought Gizmo turned into the mean one if you got him wet or fed him after midnight.
Well, he does, but there was one, the main mean one.
Mm.
I thought his name was Spike.
I don't know.
Apparently, that's a Mandela effect because his name is Stripe.
I didn't know that.
Me either, but
there's a lot of those Mandela effects I see on TikTok.
They make me feel like I'm crazy.
Yeah, because I'm sitting there going, I remember that. I do remember that. And they're like, nope.
Here's another one.
It was never, ever like that.
They are saying
uh-huh.
that the Fruit of the Loom never had a cornucopia in the label.
And I call bull.
Me too.
Because I do remember a cornucopia with the Fruit of the Loom design.
Yes, me too.
Mm-hmm.
And they're also, what was the other one that was very obvious? Oh, what was his name? Dick Clark's sidekick, Ed McMahon.
Yeah.
They're saying that Ed McMahon was never part of the, he never went to anybody's door for the
Publishers Clearinghouse?
Yes. That he was not the one that he had nothing to do with Publishers Clearinghouse.
I don't think he did. He was the spokesman for the Publishers Clearinghouse.
That's what I said.
But he didn't go to the door because that was the prize patrol. He would send the prize patrol. But
didn't he go with the prize patrol?
I don't think so. I don't know.
Listen, if y'all have any of those Mandela things.
Well, we can include that in the for next week. That's one thing, something that we can talk about.
Yeah.
So. All right.
If y'all remember any more, send them to us on Facebook.
All right. Anything else you got there, dear, before we close up? Any words of wisdom?
Just everybody be nice.
There you go.
Like I always say, just be nice.
There you go. Yeah.
Why can't we just be nice?
All right. And again, who do we got coming up on the big show, Sunday Mornings with the Tiki Man this Sunday?
We have, wait a minute. I want to make sure I get the name right because.
Andrew Dean.
Thank you. I always want to call him James and I'm like, no, wrong one. Andrew Dean and John Schneider.
Yes, you heard that right.
Bo Duke.
Andrew Dean and Bo Duke himself, John Schneider, on the big show, Sunday Mornings with the Tiki Man, this Sunday, starting at 10 a.m. And, of course, that will be broadcast live on Tiki Man Radio, TikiManRadio.com, and the Tiki Man Radio YouTube channel, courtesy of the Island J webcam. But for that, we want to thank our sponsors. Thank you to MFG Records Tropical for sponsoring our live cam here each and every week. JBL Travel Group. Of course, our OOG sponsor. We thank you for everything they do for us. And also, Goaltending Services and Outfitters in Key West. Of course, we would love for you to check out all of our amazing sponsors. And again, from somebody who is just begging for the word-of-mouth endorsements, Party Dawg Entertainment. If you know anybody who is having a party, planning a party, a wedding, it doesn't matter what it is. Tell them to check out Party Dawg Entertainment, and you can go to partydogentertainment.com. I can say it on the radio. And or check out Party Dawg Entertainment on Facebook as well. But with that being said, I think we're just about done for today, aren't we?
I think so.
All right. We will see you guys back here next week with Mr. Dave Freeman in the house. We'll see you next week, guys.
Bye, everybody.
I know it's been a lot of fun, but the set list is all done. The night was very loud and you've been a good crowd, but you know it's time to run. You've all been very kind, thank you for your time. You put me to the test as I try to address all of your requests for the night. As we look to the moon and the manager's protocol, well, I don't ever want to end, but for now, my friend's last song, last call. With this clientele, who had the drinks are flowing well. A beer sent from the bar and a healthy tip jar, a handsome tunes that I can sell. It's been a cool room, but it's ending too soon. And they remember to tip the bartender as they surrender to the tab, and they lip sync to the that they used to recall. Anytime I gotta say those words, oh no, last song, last call. Some came as ones and left by two. Still a dancing in their shoes. I break down the gear as we wind it up here. After the last song that I choose, it's the last ride near closing time. The final round poured as I strum the last chords and the guitar returns to the case. Needless to say, it was a pleasure to play for you all. Here's to toast to everyone as I finally say last song, last call. Here's a toast to everyone as I finally say last song, last call.